जी
Actually, I'm really sorry because you know it's not under my control. This is a problem of internet, so there are a lot of disturbances here in the internet. Now, after when the patient comes with to you and we take history and examination, and then finally we have to make a clinical diagnosis, and finally we have to confirm. So here the important thing is that. First of all, we confirm whether the patient is hypothyroidism or not, and then what will be the reason, and then how will you treat. For the investigations, we usually advise the thyroid profile. That's TSH, FT4, FT3. Now, in hypothyroidism, the primary, if you go for the result of these, the TSH, FT3, FT4, you'll find that TSH is markedly raised. It may be 25, maybe 30, maybe 100, maybe more than 100, depending upon the situation. And FT3, FT4 are markedly decreased. So that's the primary. But in secondary, TSH also decreased. FT3, FT4, both are decreased. So, Helen. Now, antibodies also advised because that will help you. That's the primary or secondary. If the anti-TP antibodies, antithyroidal antibodies are present, that shows the patient has primary problem in the thyroid gland. And this, so there are no need of further investigation to go for the MRI, CTR, or the pituitary. Now, the thyroid scanning sometimes needed. So that will show the decreased uptake of the technetium 99. Ultrasound is needed only when there is a goiter. In very rare cases, usually ultrasound we don't advise. So in examination, you may be asked that you may be given a scenario, and then what is the diagnosis, and what right three investigations, and our steps of the management. Now, the problem starts when there are marginal hypothyroidism, you know, when the patient usually have this value T3, T4, normal TSH is higher, but less than 10. So what should be the, how to proceed further? So when this picture occurs, then you have to go for the TSH is more than 10. Then definitely check antithyroid antibody. They're positive, stop, start therapy. They're negative, symptoms are present. Then you have to start therapy if you think. But between 5 and 10 TSH level, then antibody is positive or symptoms present, consider therapy. Antibody is negative, but TSH is between 5 and 10. So then you have to observe and retest after 6 months. So sometimes there may be the subclinical hypothyroidism. So that may be decided according to clinical features of the patient. Sometimes patient, these values should not be checked when the patient is in ICU, when severe illness, because they have different problems. So that's called the euthyroid sick syndrome. So when the patient is sick, then these tests should not be performed. Now, if you go for the treatment, there are different treatments. Goals of treatment are, first of all, reversal of the clinical progression. Now, most of the patients, they reverse completely, but the important thing is that patient has to take therapy throughout his life. This is a big problem that usually most of the patients, when they become normal, they stop therapy. So counseling is very important. Now here, one, two investigations are also important here. You see accordingly, you can go for the investigation. You can see that there are two ECG you can do, the cholesterol you can advise, and if the patient has heart problem, echocardiography can be advised. So it depends upon the clinical condition of the patient. So reversal of the clinical progression and a correction of the metabolic derangement. How it should be done? Now, drug therapy, the levothyroxine. Then treatment of the complications and surgery. Now, levothyroxine is a treatment of choice, and that's a D-thyroxine. And is available, very cheap drug, and that should be given for throughout the whole life. The starting dose is 50 microgram daily, early morning, empty stomach. This is very important. There should be empty stomach. Otherwise, the food will hinder absorption and patient will not get desired results. So very important thing is that I have to take early morning before breakfast, at least 30 minutes to 1 hour, stomach should be an MPT for the proper absorption of the drugs. So 50 microgram, one drug, single tablet should be given. And after 3 weeks, you have to increase the dose. If the patient has got a problem, cardiac failure, ischemic heart disease, and then you can decrease the dose. Starting dose should be decreased 25 micrograms, and every 3 weeks, this should be increased. Now, most of the patients, they need between 150 to 200 milligrams per day. So, and they should be taken single dose, not in divided doses. This has a long half-life. Sometimes if the patient forgets dose, no problem, he can take at any time. So this should be advised strictly that patient should have to take this drug throughout the whole life. And if the complications are there, cardiac epileptemia, cardiac failure, then yeah, there should be accordingly treatment. Now, if the patient has no complication, even that you have to go for the lipid lowering agents for a couple of months and then stop. Surgery is not really required, but sometimes patient has goiter. Then it should be advised surgery. Otherwise, there is no need of surgery in hypothyroidism. So this is hypothyroidism, and this one extreme case of exodema coma. Previously, I told you in this lecture, a thyroid is strong. Here is a myxoedema coma. So life-threatening to hypothyroidism. This can occur those patients who are first, you know, they are undiagnosed and suddenly they develop this problem. Or sometimes patient is a diagnosed case, but he has stopped therapy and he has stressful situation and can lead to the life-threatening hypothyroidism. That's called myxoedema coma. So what happens here, that patient has severe hypothermia, hypoventilation, hyponatremia, hypoglycemia, hypotension, impaired cognition, confusion, and finally coma. Now this may lead to the death, because most of the time these patients have so much severe, they're dehydrated, hypotension, everything is slow. And so usually even doing a lot of treatments, if first patient dies, 99% patient dies. Now here are some prescription factors: infection, serious respiratory and cord CNS illness, then cold exposure. Now you have to go for some investigation: blood CP, blood sugar, your electrolytes, creatinine, ECG, CT scan of brain. Sometimes maybe having the PVA, other things. Now the treatment is very difficult, but you have to do it, and mostly the patient does not survive. So intravenous use of thyroxine 4 microgram per kg, if it's available, should be given. Intravenous corticosteroid, intravenous folate electrolytes, antibiotics. Patient should be admitted in ICU, special settings, and they need vigorous efforts. But you know, I told you, the patient usually dies. Antibiotics, rewarming patient. Thanks. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much. The recording shuru karna na. Acha dance. Maine mehndi hai jo.